I tell my son, I love you every single day. Now, my dad has never said that to me. Not because he doesn't love me, but because culturally it wasn't comfortable for him. Now that he's a grandfather, he says, I love you to my son every time he sees him. My advice to all the fathers out there, forget the cultural restrictions. They grow up way too fast for you to waste even a single precious moment.
Hey guys, it's me, Isabella Gomez, filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take fire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to smokeybear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
Tell my son, I love you every single day. Now, my dad has never said that to me. Not because he doesn't love me, but because culturally it wasn't comfortable for him. Now that he's a grandfather, he says, I love you to my son every time he sees him. My advice to all the fathers out there, forget the cultural restrictions. They grow up way too fast for you to waste even a single precious moment.
Hey guys, it's Isabella Gomez filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to smokeybear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
All right, folks, we are ready to go here on the Fremont campus of Ohlone College. I would like to thank you to this afternoon's presentation of Ohlone College baseball action live from the Ohlone College Broadcasting YouTube channel. Want to quickly send a thank you to my instructors, Veronica and Gary Kalf, for allowing me to be excused from class this afternoon to bring you guys Ohlone College baseball action live here this afternoon. And want to quickly also state there will be no live stream tomorrow for the Dianza game as well as Friday for the Dianza game. Unfortunately, tomorrow softball plays one of their last two home games of the season, so that will take priority, as well as on Friday I have classes that I cannot be excused from, film class of course, which is a very, very important class for my major. Whoa, the wind is coming in. So we cannot produce live streams for baseball for either of the 2 days coming up. So we'll have to bring back baseball action next week in full force for you guys. So enjoy this while you can. But if you can, come on out 2:30 p.m. first pitch times for both games tomorrow and Friday. Now for the Renegades and the comments of Contra Costa. Let's first talk about Contra Costa. 1-18 on the season, and I want to apologize. The wind is coming in pretty hard, so it's making my microphone a little bit scuffy. As you can tell here, and I'm having trouble trying to fight it. Of course, it doesn't start blowing. The wind doesn't start blowing until first pitch. It doesn't blow at all before first pitch, but it starts blowing at first pitch. Thank you, Mother Nature. Love you. 1-18 on the season for the Comets. And they're looking for more consistency this afternoon, while for the Renegades, scoring 69 runs over the three-game series against Gavilan, including a 32-0 game. Yes, 32-0 this past Thursday against Gavilan. They're looking to just keep the form that they've been on lately, as the first pitch from Ryan Jurek in there for a strike, 0-1 count. Here it comes. It is a bunt down the third baseline. Jurek has it and throws it to first in time for the out. And that was to retire the batter number 24. And he's not listed on the roster sheet anywhere. Fantastic. That was Khalil Freeman. And Freeman is retired. Now batting is going to be number 5, Octavio Martinez. As he takes a pitch and misses the zone, 1-0, one out here in the top end of the first. And for the Renegades, they have Ryan Jurek, their right-handed pitcher, pitching this afternoon, and his 1-0 is fouled off. He's got a fastball, curveball, and changeup mixture, and Jurek, in his 8th appearance, has a 10.38 ERA. His 1-1 fouled off to the left side. Case through 9 of 14.50. And he has 14 strikeouts, 7 walks, 10 earned runs off of 11 total runs, 11 hits given up, 8.5 innings pitched. He is 1-0 on the season. His 1-2 coming home. Here it comes. Well, in the outside corner, strike 3 called. He was able to find a spot there in the outside corner for strike 3 called there on the batter Martinez. Now stepping in is going to be Jalen Edmonds, who's batting at 255 to start the season. A home run and 9 driven in with a triple. Swing and a miss there at a first pitch fastball from Ryan Jurek, who has his father in attendance as always. Down in the first row, Mr. Jurek. Here comes the 0-1 now. It's a fastball that is grounded to the right side. Fielding it is Silva over there at first, and it's a 3 unassisted there to end the inning. So for the Renegades, no walks, no hits, no runners given up, no runs given up. We'll head into the bottom end of the first. Nothing.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
And we are back here on the Fremont campus of Ohlone College. This is Armando Galan. You are listening to Ohlone Baseball Action live from the Ohlone College Broadcasting YouTube channel. Just want to quickly state for the record, we are having just a tiny bit of service issues. My current hotspot runs on T-Mobile, and T-Mobile is running pretty slow right now. So if the stream starts getting a little bit spotty, we do have some ways of trying to control it, but I'm going to need our comment section to really keep me updated on that because I cannot monitor that. So just for those of you listening at home or at work, if you notice that there are any points where the stream health quality and, like, you know, if it's lagging, if it's starting to get spotty, let me know. I can try some things, but most likely they won't work. I can still try them though, because apparently, according to IT, they do work. All right, here we are. Bottom end of the first inning. Standing in to bat now is going to be Matthew Leiderman. He is getting the starting nod this afternoon at second base as he takes a fastball well inside for a ball. Batting from the right side batter's box, playing at second base this afternoon and leading off to start this game. Batting at 297 to start this game. His batting average was dipped in the low 220s, so it has raised up in recent memory, which is good for him, and I imagine that he has a lot of pride in that batting average starting to get up there in the 300 range. 1-1, fastball in the outside corner, missing the zone. The pitcher this afternoon is going to be Derek Morelli, and he has an ERA of 22.5 to start this game. This 2-1 is fouled off to the right side by Leiderman. And that is recorded through only 3 appearances. It is his 4th appearance on the season, so definitely try and temper your numbers there, as he is 0-1 on the season with 12 innings pitched, 23 hits given up, 22 runs, 21 earned runs, 10 walks, 6 strikeouts, K's through 9 to 4.5, and 3 home runs given up. His 2-2 bounces on the outside part of the plate, 3-2. So now with the 3-2, here comes home. It's a fastball challenge inside that Leiderman fouls off to the right side and out of play. The catcher number 23, trying to see if I can find his name here on any of the sheets. I cannot. 3-2. Too high and outside, and Leiderman is going to walk to start this game. So that's exactly what the doctor ordered for the Renegades. Here now is Cameron Calvillo. I believe the catcher is number... I have no idea who the catcher is. 23 is his number, but I don't see a 23 listed on the roster sheet. So, here it comes. Fastball way high and inside there. And Calvillo ducking for dear life to protect his noggin up there. That's definitely not something he wants to take, a fastball well up there. Able to duck out of the way, and now heading the count 1-0. Now on the 1-0, Leiderman is going to steal second. The pitch is inside. It's called a ball. Leiderman is safe at second with a stolen base. So another stolen base there for Matthew Leiderman. That will be good for his 4th of the season. The 2-0 to Calvillo misses the zone, and it is 3-0 now. And Calvillo having himself a great season as well, batting at 351, 2 homers driven out, and 23 driven in. 464 on base and 519 slugging. The 3-0 is in there for a strike on a fastball there from the picture from the pitcher Marilli. So now Marilli getting the sign. Here it comes now. Well inside, and Calvillo will now walk. Runners at second and first with none out. And here comes a very, very dangerous renegade bat in the form of Jackson Nystrom. And he is the biggest power threat that any of the renegade teams would have seen that I've worked with in the last 2 years. 9 home runs, 34 driven in, 463 on base, or sorry, batting average, 550 on base, and 912 slugging. As his 0-0 is high and inside for a ball. Nystrom now awaiting for Marilli. Here it comes. It's popped straight up and fouled out of play. And so now with the 1-1, Nystrom awaits for Marilli. Here it comes. Inside, almost hitting him. Count now 2-1. And Jackson Nystrom, with all the slugging that he has done this season, on no triples on the season. And his 2-1 on the ground through the infield. Foul down the third baseline. And that definitely could have plated a few runners there. Potentially could have plated Calvillo as it was weakly hit down the third baseline. Nystrom now going to step back in the box. Has to try and find a way here to get back to ball action in a 2-2 count. Here it comes. It is a breaking ball just missing the zone there on the outside part of the plate. 3-2 now. As Marilli gets the sign now from his catcher. And they agree on the sign. Here comes a 3-2 pitch. Both runners stealing, and it's a foul back to the screen from Jackson Nystrom. So we'll reset and do it again. I imagine Marilli probably does not want to walk three straight batters to start the game. But that's it. What he is in danger of doing. Could be walking the bases loaded. 3-2 now. Marilli kicks and deals. Both runners stealing again. It's a pitch inside. Call for a ball. And the bases are now loaded on three straight walks to start this game with Jaden Arakaki now up. And so Arakaki's season so far looking like this. Batting at 393 to start the game. 481 on base and 508 slugging. He's got a home run and 23 driven in. So Arakaki now standing in as there was a mound visit from the Comets. The 0-0 here comes. It's a fastball fouled off to the left side and into the tree line. So heads up, birds, your home is being invaded by a baseball. 0-1 is now the count. Now the 0-1 to Arakaki, well outside. Ball one. Arakaki now with the 1-1, waiting for Marilli. Here it comes. Morelli, rather, and it is on the outside corner, 2-1 now. Jaden looking for something to hit here in this 2-1 count with the bases loaded and none out here in the bottom of the first. It is on the ground to the right side, bouncing play. Goes to second for one, back to first, not in time. Jaden is safe. Nystrom is out. Leiterman scores. It is 1-0, Ohlone College. So here now is Silva. And Joe Silva batting at 269 to start this game. He takes a fastball inside and low for a strike. That's a good old 3-3, or really, 3-3 spot actually, rather. Could be a 1-3 or a 3-3 depending on, you know, your terminology. Of course, we're talking about the pitch grid here. As on this 0-1, Arakaki steals second, and he is safe on the steal there. Kind of slid a little bit awkwardly. I thought he might have injured himself, so I kind of held my breath there, but he was safe. And Calvillo was propped up ready to go at third there in case there was going to be an error on the throw. So another stolen base for the Renegades here. Pitch was called a strike on the 1-0 count steal. So here comes the 1-1 now. And Silva fouls this one off to the right side. 1-2. Silva with the home run on the season and 10 driven in. Here comes the 1-2 now. Silva breaking pitch on the outside corner, and it is called a ball. And the wind very, very awkwardly here. Pushing in. Usually it carries out to the outfield, but it is carrying its way into the outfield. So here comes the 2-2. Fastball swung on and missed by Silva, and he will be set down on strikes. So with two out, here is Josh Algorin. Now with the 0-0 to Josh, he check swings on a fastball and saying, the home plate umpire saying he went there on that check swing, strike one. So now with the 0-1, here comes Algorin fouls this one back to the screen, 0-2. The Renegades without a hit so far. Really now looking try and put away Josh here as the 0-2 is missed low and inside. So now the count is 1-2. Here it comes home. Algorin fouls this one off to the left side. Stevie Hom on deck. That is definitely a bat in this situation that the Renegades want to see and the Comets want to avoid. 1-2 count. Here it comes now from Morelli, and it misses the zone. 2-2. Josh now with the 2-2. Fouls this one to the right side, a bouncing foul ball there. So now the count 2-2. Here comes home again. It is a bouncing play called foul and Josh will stay alive again here. So Josh, stepping out of the box and taking some time here as the Comets are communicating or getting communication out from the dugout on this crucial 2-2 count here early in the game. Here it comes home. It's a fastball that is on the outside corner and fouled off to the left side again here by Josh. He's really trying to work his opposite field approach here. So now on a 2-2 count again, here it comes home. Algorin takes inside and it bounces to the plate, 3-2 now. So now with a 3-2 count, here comes from Murillo. And it is low and too far inside. So Josh will walk. It is the fourth walk for the Renegades here in this first inning. And now here is Stevie Hom. And Stevie Hom, you want to talk about dangerous. This is the bat right here. 2 home runs on the season, 11 driven in through 33 at bats, 273 batting, 419 on base, and 545 slugging. Here comes his 0-0. It's a, looked like a slider there actually that misses the zone on the outside corner. And Stevie Hom stepping back out, taking a little practice swing, now steps back into the box. Murillo gets the sign. Here it comes. It is a fastball that almost bounces to the plate. Too low and outside for a ball as well. 2-0. Now Stevie awaits his 2-0. Here it comes. It is popped straight up. And back, the catcher not seeing it, and it lands right next to me. Two and one. And how funny is this? I actually see my classmates for the class that I am missing watching the game in left field. So hi, classmates, if you're listening. Johan, Richard, I see you guys up there. 2-1, here it comes home. Fastball challenge inside on a 3-1 zone, or the 3-1 spot, and it is called a strike to make it 2-2. And that is a pitcher perfect 3-1 spot there. Up and in on a right-hander's hands. Here comes the 2-2 now. And this is fouled off to the left side deep, and it had the home run distance. Oh man, just in front of it there is Stevie Hom. So he's gonna take his little Stevie Strot, take a practice swing, get back in the box. He's gonna tell himself here, I'm right on that. And he was. For Murillo, he's gonna tell himself that was just a very long strike. Here's your 2-2 again, inside, almost hitting Stevie. 3-2 is the count now. And Stevie battling here. So here comes the 3-2 now to Stevie Hom with the bases loaded and two out. All runners are stealing. It's a fastball fouled off to the right side. So now Stevie standing back in the box. Murillo just a pitch away here from getting out of this jam. 3-2, all the runners stealing again. Swung on and missed there by Stevie Hom and Murillo. It's not very often that you face six batters in an inning without giving up a base hit, but he did that. He walked four of them, but was able to limit the damage to one run there on that jam. And you have to think of that being an absolute win if you are the Comets. We'll head into the top end of the second. It is 1-0 Renegades.
told the driver I gotta call everybody.
It's okay.
Luke! 911, where is your emergency?
Everyone's on the way. What happened?
So we are back here on the Ohlone College Fremont campus. This is Armando Galan. You are listening to Ohlone College Baseball Action live from the Ohlone Broadcasting YouTube channel. And Renegades were able to accumulate four walks in the inning, but only being able to score one of them, as there were no base hits given up by the starting pitcher Murillo on the Comet side. So now batting will be number 27, Jesus Contreras, and Contreras is batting at 240 to start this afternoon. 278 on base and 240 slugging. He fouls off his 0-1 to the right side, or his 0-0 to the right side. Here comes his 0-1, and it's on the ground. A Stevie Hom over there at short, back over to first, and a perfect 6-3 there to start the inning. So now with the 0-0, here comes, and it's a strike on the outside corner there on a fastball by Ryan Jurek to welcome the new batter, number 3, Ansel Carson. And Carson awaiting his 0-1 from Jurek. Here it comes. It's a fastball in there for a strike on the lower inner half. So now with the 0-2, Jurek in the commanding spot here in this at-bat. 0-2 bounces to the plate, 1-2 now. Now the 1-2 to Carson from Jurek. Here it comes. It is on the outside corner. And missing the zone, 2-2. Two two now from Jurek to Carson, with the wind pretty much dying down almost entirely. It's a fastball in there, strike three called. Carson did not like the call there. As hey, I mean, whatever he says goes. So, Jurek with another strikeout. Here now is the batter number 6, Marcus Watkins. Watkins batting from the right side. Takes a fastball and almost bounced to the plate there. And a good job wearing it by the catcher, Nathan Wood, who is getting his first start in a while, at least from the games that I've been seeing. Watkins batting at 194. And he's under the dreaded Mendoza line, so he definitely wants to probably rise that up in this game. As the 1-0 bounces to the plate, it is 1-1, or it is bounced and fouled. Not bounced to the plate. Bounced and fouled, and it's 1-1. And we've had just under 100 people click on this afternoon to listen to this game. 1-1 in their first strike. Just under 100, and we're not even midway through the second inning. That is pretty good. Pretty good, my friends. Keep the interactions up. Keep listening. So now with the 1-2, here comes home from Ryan Jurek. Inside, missing the zone. 2-2. Jurek now with a 2-2, gets the sign. Here it comes. Fastball swung on and missed. 1-2-3 inning for the Renegades, and they lead this game by a score of 1-0. We'll be back in 30 seconds after this break.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
All right, here we are, folks. We are back on the Fremont campus of Ohlone College. This is Armando Galan. You are listening to Ohlone College Baseball Action live from the Ohlone Broadcasting YouTube channel. And due up for the Renegades is Voltaggio Wood and Leiterman. Here now is Nino Voltaggio as he's going to square up to bunt, and it's a hard bunt down the third baseline, and it is scuffed up at third base. Voltaggio is going to be safe there, and let's see how this is going to be scored, if it's going to be scored an error or not, and it is going to be scored an error. So Voltaggio reaches on an error. Is it going to be an E5 on a bunt there? So here now is Nathan Wood, and Wood batting at 301 to start this game, a 489 on base and 485 slugging. He's got a homer and 9 driven in. Here comes the 0-0. Way inside there to the right-handed batter, Nathan Wood. And so now with the 1-0, here it comes. Fastball inside, missing the zone, 2-0. Nathan Wood now getting instructions from the dugout. So he steps back in. And Voltaggio stealing a base here. It's a fastball challenge right over the heart of the plate, and it is a called strike there. Voltaggio is safe at second, so Renegades 3-for-3 so far with stolen base opportunities in this game. And so now with the 2-1, Murillo kicks and deals. And it's a bunt down the third baseline again. Third baseman trying to barehand it, but he lets it go foul last minute there. And it was a really good instinctive play there by the third baseman, number 3, Carson, to let that roll foul, get Wood back in the box on a 2-strike count. Now you can't bunt the runner over, and so you need decent contact to move the runner up. So it's a good opportunity to get an unproductive out. Two, two, missing the zone there, and it is 3-2 now. Of course, the danger is you got Matthew Leiderman, who is one of the better bunters on this team, on deck, and he could have two runners on if Wood finds a way aboard. You can move them both up into scoring position. 3-2, here it comes. It bounces to the plate, and Wood will be the fifth walked batter in this game for the Renegades. Man, if I had a dollar for each time I said a Renegade batter has walked, I'd have five whole dollars. That's pretty good, my friends. If I do say so myself, I'd be pretty rich. Here now is Matthew Leiderman. And guess what? Well, he walked in his first opportunity. He is the only run scored for the Renegades so far. Number 19. Fastball in there for a strike on his second at bat, first delivery there from Rio, and now he's going to get a sign from Curran in the dugout. It's Calvillo stretching, getting loose in the box here, and Leiderman squaring up to bunt, now pulling it back and swinging away, and it's a bouncing ball to the second baseman. He fields it, throws it to first in time for the out, but no double play there, and so it works just as good as a bunt for the Renegades. As the Comets were playing bunt defense, they are bringing the infielders in. So swinging away there was Leiderman, moving the runners up. So it is a productive 4-3 ground out for the Renegades. As Wood moves up to, Voltaggio moves up to third, and Wood moves up to second. And tagging up here on a pop-up from Calvillo was Voltaggio. It gets past the catcher. Voltaggio is going to commit now, and he is safe at home plate. As he immediately was going there, and it was shallow contact to center field on the fly ball there, so it'll be a sacrifice fly for Calvillo. A sack seven for him. It was medium distance, or shallow distance there, so Voltaggio put on the brakes, but then the throw back to home got past the catcher, and so Voltaggio read it the entire way and gunned it down the line and scored there on a big play to make the score 2-0. Some great situational base running on display there by Voltaggio. That's the 0-0 to our new batter. Nystrom misses the zone. Now the 1-0. Popped straight up and fouled to the right side. And so now, on a 1-1 count, Nystrom awaits. Here comes home. Fastball fouled off to the right side. 1-2. And so now with the 1-2 count, Nystrom awaits for Murillo. And it's a pickoff play back to second. Not in time there to get or to catch Nathan Wood napping at second base. And he's a good base runner, especially for a catcher, a very fast base runner. You don't expect catchers to be very fast, but Nathan Wood is an exception. As Nystrom is on the ground here to the left side, shortstop having trouble with it, and it'll be an infield single. And get this. It is 2-0 Renegades, and that is the first base hit of the game for the Renegades. Credit it to Jackson Nystrom. Wood moving up to third on the play. Here now is Eric Hockey. Eric Hockey awaiting. Here it comes. Inside on a fastball, and Nystrom is stealing second, and he is safe. Renegades perfect with stealing bases today. Oh my goodness. 6 for 6 on stolen bases to start this game. We are only in the bottom end of the second inning. Here comes the 1-0 now. And it hits Arakaki on the foot. Here now is Joe Silva. Hi, Joe. And this is your golden opportunity, my friend, first baseman this afternoon. I just realized I didn't even go over the defensive alignment. I'll do that in the next half inning. My goodness. It's never too late to go over the defensive alignment. Here comes the 0-0. Silva takes way high there for a ball, 1-0. I didn't even clear my asset for the last at-bat. It's 1-0, and bases are loaded. All right, count now 1-0. Silva waiting for Murillo. Here it comes. Fastball swung on and missed there. He wanted it on the outer half. Couldn't quite connect with it. Now with the 1-1 count, Silva, here it comes. Fastball pops straight up into center field. Medium distance, the center fielder under it, and that'll do it. Renegades having bases loaded in both of the opening frames, but can't quite cash in on them. Only 2-0 here is the score as we will head into the top end of the third. Renegades lead, we'll be back in 30 seconds.
I tell my son, I love you, every single day. Now my dad has never said that to me. Not because he doesn't love me, but because culturally it wasn't comfortable for him. Now that he's a grandfather, he says, I love you to my son every time he sees him. My advice to all the fathers out there, forget the cultural restrictions. They grow up way too fast for you to waste even a single precious moment.
So I feel like I say this every time we have a game here at Ohlone College, but so far, a very weird start to this game. The Renegades with two bases loaded opportunities and not really cashing in the bases loaded opportunities whatsoever. Both runs coming with two runners on and very, very awkward plays made by the Comets as Jurek starts his third inning with a strike to his next batter. This next pitch is on the ground to the right side, and Leiderman has it, throws it to first in time to get Miguccia. So Miguccia down on two pitches. Let's talk about the defensive alignment. I haven't yet announced it. I don't know why I haven't, but left to right, it's Nystrom, Algarin and Arakaki in the outfield. Left to right in the infield, it's Calvillo, Hom, Leiderman, and Silva. And Wood is catching. Jurek is pitching. As the 0-0 misses the zone from Jurek, 1-0. So now with the 1-0, here it comes. And it is popped straight up into right field. Arakaki ranging all the way over. And Rob Crivello is down on two pitches himself. Four pitches and two outs. And here now is number 23. Fastball missing the zone there. And if there are any Comet fans that are in the Comet section, let me know who number 23 is, because he's not listed on the roster or the stat sheet. Mr. Elusive, what's the word? Mysterious player. There we go. Mr. Mysterious. As the 1-0 misses the zone, 2-0. Now the 2-0, too far inside there, 3-0. Jurek. Now awaiting his, or now going to throw his 3-0 in there for a strike there. Trying to stay consistent in the zone here. 3-1, here it comes. Fastball missing the zone. Number 23 will walk. Khalil Freeman, the next batter for the Comets. As Jurek kicks and deals in there for a strike there on what looks like a curveball off the right hand of Ryan Jurek. So now with the 0-1, Jurek trying to pick off the batter, or the base runner number 23 off of first base to no avail there. We have 100 total viewers here in the third inning, so thank you all so much for listening. The 0-1, here it comes. Fastball check swung, and going there is Freeman. He is not happy about that call there. So that pitch was well high and inside there, almost hit him directly in the face. I think that was more of a self-defense move there than an actual swing, but he went around, says the home plate umpire. So here comes the 0-2 count now, or the 0-2 delivery from Jurek. Here it comes. It is a changeup that finds a hole in the infield there for a base hit. So two runners on now and two out. Here now is Octavio Martinez. Martinez with no RBIs on the season. Looking to try and come through here as time is going to be called by Nathan Wood to go talk to Ryan Jurek. So far, Jurek is looks pretty confident and loose on the bump this afternoon. So here comes the 0-0 delivery now from Jurek to Martinez. Martinez swung on and fouled off to the right side, 0-1. And so now with the 0-0, here comes home from Jurek. Bouncing to the plate and missing the zone, 1-1. And a good stop there by Nathan Wood to avoid a wild pitch or even a pass ball there. Martinez battling here, trying to find a way to keep the line moving. Here it comes. He swings and fouls this one off to the left side. 1-2 the count now. So now 1-2 is the count. And Martinez. Ready. Jurek ready. Here comes the 1-2. Fastball inside, missing the zone, 2-2. So now the 2-2 from Jurek with two out. Here it comes home. It's a fastball swung on and missed, and Jurek gets the pivotal strikeout there to end the inning. So danger averted for the Renegades. A little bit of a scare, but nothing more. We'll head into the bottom end of the third inning. Score is 2-0, Renegades.
Hey guys, Isabella Gomez filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
And here we are, folks, back on the Ohlone College Fremont campus. This is Armando Galan, and Josh Algarin will start this next inning for the Renegades, which has been a slow start offensively for the Renegades. Only one hit, but there has been two runs scored at least, and that really is attributed to some of the really great base running that we have been seeing so far. 6 out of 6 stolen base opportunities successful for the Renegades. Josh Algren with a flare out to center field. Center fielder able to range all the way over to make the play there. And a great play, losing his cap on the play. I believe that is number 4, Jalen Edmonds. So here now is Stevie Hahn, and his 0-0, missing the zone, 1-0. So now with the 1-0, here it comes home. Fastball in there for a strike to Stevie Hahn. The wind now pushing out to the outfield instead of in from the outfield. So wind back to normal here at Ohlone College. But what is normal in this world anymore? 1-0, fastball in there for a strike on the outside lower half part of the plate. That's your good old 1-3 spot. 1-2, here it comes. Tried the 1-3 spot again, but this time kind of bounced to the plate and is 2-2. Voltaggio on deck for the Renegades. Two-two, here it comes. Bouncing to the plate again. 3-2 now. So now with the 3-2 from Murillo, here it comes home. And Stevie able to watch it there on the lower inner half. And a good job there by Stevie as he'll take first base there on a good leave. Here now is Nino Voltaggio. And so this is now the Renegades. Let me just count them real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sixth base on balls. As Voltaggio, his 0-0 is flared out to the right side. The right fielder off of his glove. And Hom is going to round second and head to third. He is safe at third. And Voltaggio had his stay put at first as everybody thought that that was going to be an automatic put out there. And so that'll be marked an error. An E9. Hom goes to third, Voltaggio to first. Here now is Nathan Wood. The 0-0 to Nathan Wood, it's a bunt that was missed there by Nathan Wood, but Voltaggio is able to steal second, so make that now 7-for-7 for the Renegades in stealing bases. Pitch called a strike to Nathan Wood. I imagine that the current special is on its way. No, it will not be, actually. Fastball on the outside corner, missing the zone, 1-1. And the infield is playing in as they are probably anything on the ground here going to go home to try and throw out Stevie Hom. So now 1-1. Here it comes. Fastball lower outer half. Missing the zone. 2-1. Nathan now. With a 2-1, here it comes. It's a double steal and a bunt. It is popped up and it is caught at third base on a throwback to back to third to the shortstop covering for a double play. It was going to be a double steal and a bunt there, but it was popped up by Nathan Wood. And wow, that is a bit awkward of a play. That is something that the Renegades run very often there, but we have not seen a result like that in a while. And I imagine that is not going to be a happy response from Coach Curran. We'll head into the top end of the fourth and a great defensive play by the Comets. 2-0 Renegades.
I tell my son, I love you every single day. Now my dad has never said that to me. Not because he doesn't love me, but because culturally it wasn't comfortable for him. Now that he's a grandfather, he says, I love you to my son every time he sees him. My advice to all the fathers out there, forget the cultural restrictions. They grow up way too fast for you to waste even a single precious moment.
We got a new pitcher to tell you about, folks, and the pitcher is Joey Stover, and I got updated pitching information because I heard from Stover that the pitching information that I got from our good old pitching coach, Mr. T.C. Fairfield, was incorrect, T.C. Thank you. No, I'm just kidding. So the updating information says sinker, force team changeup, curve, knuckle curveball, and forkball from Joey Stover. And I said, forkball? That is like, what? I have never met somebody that throws a forkball. So, he said, in his words exactly, it's a unicorn pitch. It rarely comes out, but when it comes out, it is nasty. His words exactly. So let's see what happens here as he awaits his first batter, and Jalen Edmonds to start this top end of the fourth. His 0-0, missing the zone, 1-0. Let's talk about Joey Stover's season so far. This will be his sixth appearance. He's got 5 1/3 pitched. 3 hits given up, 7 runs, 6 earned, 9 walks, 12 strikeouts, a K through 9 of 20.25, and a ERA of 10.13. His 1-0 misses the zone, and it's 2-0. And who scored for the Renegades? It was Voltaggio and Leiterman. Here comes the 2-0 now. In there for a strike on the 2-0 count. Looked like a sinker off the left hand of Joey Stover. And yeah, he's a left-handed pitcher, folks. Yeah, we have those now here at Ohlone College. Fastball way inside on the shins there to Edmonds, and he's able to duck away from it, juke away from it. 3-1 now. Stover, a little bit wild coming out of the pin so far. His fastball in there for a strike. It's like he heard me. I'm going to say it again real quick and see if I get the similar result. Stover, a little bit wild coming out of the pin so far. Here it comes, 3-2. There it is. Swung. Not even swung on a miss. It is a backwards K there. Oh, man. What a pitch there from Joey Stover on the fastball there. To sit down, Edmonds looking. Here now is Contreras. Now with the 0-0. It's a fastball swung on and missed by Contreras. 0-1 is the count now. And Stover now dealing. I think whatever I said definitely helped him. 100%. 0-1, here it comes. Inside. Now, see, I said he's dealing. He throws a ball. I said twice that he's struggling to find the zone. He throws a strike. Let's see what happens here when I say he's struggling to find the zone. Just going to play a little game here with you folks. 1-1, here it comes. Okay, we're going to stop this game now. Well inside there for a ball, 2-1. Contreras so far in the season batting at .240, a .278 on base, and .240 slugging. 11 driven in, 1 walk, and 11 strikeouts. As he pops this 2-1 up, and back to the screen, 2-2. Not a big attendance this afternoon for the Renegades. It's a bit awkward to have a Monday afternoon baseball game here on the Fremont campus, but that's what's happened. 2-2, swung on and missed there for a second strikeout of the inning for Joey Stover. Speaking of Monday games, currently our softball team is at LMC and playing a two-game set. Want to let you guys know, of course, again, no broadcast tomorrow. We are going to divert resources to our softball game as softball is having their final two home games of the regular season this month. So that does kind of take priority, unfortunately. However, don't worry. We got plenty of home games left for our baseball guys. And as well as if they keep on going at this rate, we will have maybe some playoff home games. Not a wood table, but whatever. 0-1, here it comes. Well outside and high there. And no stream will happen on Friday either, as I do have film class, unfortunately. So we'll have to see you guys again next week with baseball action. 1-1, fouled off to the right side. So the 1-2 now from Joey Stover. Here it comes home. Fastball. Strike three called. And Stover did not move at all there until the home plate umpire made his call. And when he did, he gave him a nice little shake of the head and walked off the mound. We'll head into the bottom end of the fourth inning. The score is 2-0, Renegades.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
We got a new pitcher to tell you about for the Comets. It is going to be their second baseman and pitcher combination in Rob Crivello. And Crivello, so far on the season, making his fifth appearance on the season, 1-1 on the season. With a 9.5 innings pitched, he's got 23 hits given up, 27 runs, 21 earned runs, 9 walks to 8 strikeouts, 7.45 Ks through 9, 2 home runs given up, and a 19.55 ERA. His ERA is just 10 years removed from World War II, so there's that. And here now, standing in the box, is going to be Matthew Leiderman. After Nathan Wood bunted into a double play to end the bottom end of the third. Here we are in the top end of the fourth as Leiderman swings on and missed there on the first pitch from Crivello, the submariner, with his 0-1 in their first strike, 0-2 now. And Leiderman got to try and battle here. 0-for-1 on the afternoon with a walk, and he scored a run. 0-2, bouncing to the plate, making the count now 1-2. So now with the 1-2, strike three called there to Matthew Leiderman. Did not like the strike three call there. So he will go down on a backwards K. Here now is Cameron Calvillo. And his 0-0 misses the zone. 1-0 is the count now. And with the 1-0, picking and dealing is Crivello, and it is a 1-0 that is lined out to deep center field, and a dive by the center fielder. No good. Calvillo rounding second, heading to third. He is safe with a triple there. That's got to be rough if you're an outfielder. You give it all you got on your effort there to try and field a really hard hit ball. All you do is just come up with a face full of dirt and a dropped ball that ends up in a huge extra base hit. It's got to be rough. But for the Renegades, nothing better there than a dropped ball. As the first pitch doesn't even come to the plate. It's a pickoff play, but the third baseman not playing on the bag there, so there was no way that they were even going to have a chance to have Calvillo there. Nystrom now waiting his 0-0. It's a slider that kind of bounces to the zone there, 1-0. Here comes the 1-0. Swung on and missed. And so now with the 1-0, or the 1-1, here it comes home. Fouled back to the screen by Nystrom, 1-2. Now the 1-2, here it comes home. Slider bouncing to the plate. And a good sliding stop there by the catcher to keep it in front of him. 2-2. Now the 2-2 home. Here it comes. It bounces to the plate. 3-2. And Crivello really trying to find the zone here. As a strikeout would be huge in this situation. Here it comes, 3-2. Fastball bouncing to the plate and gets away from him. Calvillo is going to move up and score on a wild pitch there on the 3-2 count. 3-0 Renegades in good situational base running there as Nystrom is going to walk on the play. And just several mistakes. That is now the 7th walked batter in this game for the pitching staff for the Comets. They're doing a good job, though, managing him. As this first pitch is in there for a strike, and Nystrom is going to take second uncontested. What is that now? 8-for-8 on stolen base attempts for the Renegades? So the 0-1 here comes, bouncing to the plate and missing the zone. 1-1. Here it comes to Eric Hockey. Inside, and it bounces away from the catcher. Nystrom is going to move up 90 feet on the play. Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me here if now Jaden gets the call from the dugout to try and lay down a bunt here. But the infield is playing in, so I imagine that's not going to happen. Swung on and missed there on the 2-1 from Eric Hockey. 2-2 now. So definitely that wasn't the case, and the infield's going to back off now as the bunt play is now kind of over with. Actually, no, one out. They're not going to back off here. 2-2 outside for a ball. 3-2. So infield still playing in here on this 3-2 count. Any ground ball is going to go straight to home. Here's a ground ball to third, or to first, and it's going to be a 3 unassisted, staring down Nystrom is the first baseman, number 6, Watkins. He's going to get the 3 unassisted there and make sure that Nystrom stays right where he's at. So there are now 2 out. Here's Joe Silva as he takes inside on a breaking pitch. 1-0 is the count now. With the wind pushing out to center field. Here comes the 1-0. And Silva fouls this one off to the right side. 1-1 now. Got a just a mini announcement when we lead back into the top end of the fifth inning. So I'll let you guys know when we get there. 1-1, here it comes. Slider in there for a strike to Silva. 1-2. So yeah, listen very closely for when we come back from the commercial break. 1-2, bouncing to the plate and hitting Silva there. It got away from the catcher again, but it was a hit-by-pitch to Silva. So no pass ball, no wild pitch, no chance to score a run there. Here now is Josh Algorin. And Josh Algorin now going to come up to hit. Here we go. Silva is going to steal now, and the throw to second, not in time. Silva makes it 9-for-9 on stolen base attempts. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Pass for the ball.
Oh, misses the zone there, and a throwback to Sertz and Nystrom as it looked like he was gonna try and get off the bag there on a potential wild throw. It was not in time, and this is a 1-0 grounded to the right side by Algorin, and that'll do it. A 3 unassisted to end the inning. And so we will head into the top end of the fifth. We'll be back in 30 seconds. I got an announcement for you guys when we come back from the break. We'll be back. All right, fans, so just got my information corrected there. The Renegades are indeed 9-for-9 on stolen base attempts. So quickly wanted to make a quick announcement. I've been accepted to 6 different state universities across the California State University system, and 2 of which that are notable, Fresno State and San Diego State. So I wanted to make the announcement and let you guys know this will be the final year in the final semester that I will be here at Ohlone College. And if anybody that is listening would want to take the reins as the broadcast announcer, we have broadcasting opportunities for our volleyball team, for our basketball teams, our softball and baseball teams, even our soccer teams. You can get out there and get some stuff done for our soccer teams as well, which is something I wasn't able to do here in my time at Ohlone College. So if you want to, try your opportunity here at Ohlone, make sure to contact Chris Warden. You can find his contacts on the Ohlone Athletics .com website. And, I mean, if you even just Google it, it'll show up right there. Just Chris Warden's email, basically. Go ahead and contact him if you are interested in the media assistant position here at Ohlone College. Yeah, folks, it has been an unbelievable ride, and we are going to make this the best possible final semester we can make this before it is time for me to go. So play resumes here as Marcus Watkins, who had himself 2-3 unassisted plays, will lead off here against Joey Stover, as the fastball there from Stover misses the zone, and it is 1-0. And so now with the 1-0, here it comes. It's a fastball again on the outer half, missing the zone, 2-0. Here comes the 2-0. Fastball in there, strike called. And Stover looking pretty loose on the bump this afternoon. And the 2-1. Missing the zone there, but too elevated. 3-1. Watkins under the Mendoza line this afternoon at 194. Trying to find a couple of base hits here. Here comes the 3-1. Swung on and missed there. 3-2. So now with the 3-2, Stover comes back with the fastball, swung on and missed there for another strikeout. And here now is CBN. He is a freshman utility player, batting at 160 to start this game, and on base of 267 and slugging at 160. His 0-0 misses the zone and it is 1-0. Fastball from Stover missing the zone, 2-0. Want to talk about real quick our gender sex education fair here at Ohlone College. Going to be happening on August 19th, brought to you by the communication department. They put a lot of work into it, a ton of family and sex ed classes working on these presentations. If you guys want, they'll be on the fourth level on the Fremont campus of Ohlone College on the 19th of April. It is always such a huge event, full of a lot of games, a lot of food, and a lot of education, of course. So come on out and come be a part of the festivities. The communication department definitely wants you there. 2-2, here it comes. Swung on and missed. Two strikeouts there for Joey Stover. And now coming up to hit is going to be number 7, Rob Crivello, and Crivello picked up the wrong bat and went to go throw the bat that he originally picked up back into the dugout. Somebody threw him back his bat. Here comes the 0-0 now. Whoa, inside there, had to slide away from that one. 1-0 the count. Here comes the 1-0 now. And it missed the zone again, 2-0, as Stover really lighting up the speedometer there. 2-0, here it comes. Fastball in there, registering at 87, 2-1. Here it comes now. Another pitch, just barely missing the zone there. A little bit too far inside. So Stove looking to try and find the zone here. 3-1. Tried him with the sinker, didn't work. And he is going to walk Crivello.
Go, bud, pound it.
And here now is the mysterious batter, number 23. It seems like every single game, there's always somebody who is not listed on the roster sheet, not listed on the stat sheets. And it always seems to be a number 20. 20-something. Either it's 21, 23, or 25. Funny enough, those are baseball numbers. 0-0, here it comes. Trying him with the sinker in there for a strike. And the 0-1 now. It's a breaker that misses the zone, 1-1. Snover looking to try and find the zone now. Having some trouble here after setting the last two, or the first two batters of the inning down on strikes. The 1-1 fouled off. And was that caught by one of the guys? It was unbelievable. That was caught by one of the players, one of the Comet players in their dugout over there. Oh my goodness. Hey, that counts as an out though, right? No, I'm just kidding. What a play there. It's so stupid. 1-2, here it comes. Bender missing the zone. 2-2. Stover now with a 2-2. Looking to try and find the zone. Steps off now to kind of just recollect his thoughts here. 2-2 now again from Stover. Here it comes. Sinker in there for a strike. And so Stover will set three of them down with strikes, although walking one of them. And we will head into the top end of the, or the bottom end of the fifth inning. 3-0 is the score, Renegades lead.
Hey guys, it's me, Isabella Gomez, filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to SmokeyBear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
We are back, folks, here on the Ohlone College Broadcasting YouTube channel, and it's been a game so far that just feels like it's moving in slow motion a little bit, even with the Renegades leading by a score of 3-0, just not really clicking so far, and that's really hard to talk about when you're saying the team is winning 3-0. The Renegades with 7 walked batters on the afternoon and only 3 hits. And 3 runs scored. Here now is Stevie Hom, and he will start this bottom end of the fifth inning. as he takes a pitch that was elevated in the zone there and missing the count, or missing the zone, 1-0, and his 1-0 also missing the count. What am I saying? Missing the zone. I'm trying to move the count here, which is one of my assets to you know, actually update the graphical information for you guys. Trying to move it back down to the folder that it's supposed to be, and it says count on there, and I keep on saying count instead of zone. I don't know why. ADHD moment. 2-0 in the strike zone, though. 2-1 now. Stevie awaits, and he pops this one high and deep to left field, and bye, bye, baby! Hummer is a bomber, folks! As he hits a solo home run here in the bottom on the bottom half of the fifth inning, and Stevie takes the grand tour for the third time this season. So let's get that bye bye baby rolling in the chat. Hashtag bye bye baby. Hummer is a bomber. Here now is Nino Voltaggio in a 4-0 game for the Renegades. Oh, well, here it comes. It's a slider missing the zone there. 1-0 the count. Now with the 1-0, here it comes. Looked like a fastball there off of the hands of off the right hand of Crivello. It's called strike. His 1-1 missing the zone. 2-1 now. Here comes the 2-1 now. Fouled off inside by Voltaggio and back to the right side screen there. 2-2 now. Here it comes, bouncing to the plate on the outside part of the plate there. And if Voltaggio was a left-hander, that would have hit him right across the foot. So thank goodness he's not a lefty. 3-2 now to Voltaggio. And he fouls this one off inside, and somehow he fouls it off into the batting cage. No, not onto the batting cage, inside of it. It's got to be a shot, a really precise shot in order to get it in there. 3-2 now again. Here it comes. Voltaggio watches it, and it is on the outside part of the plate. That is now the eighth Renegade walk in this game. Here now is Nathan Wood. His 0-0 fouled back and off the mask of the catcher for the Comets, number 23. And he looks okay. Didn't even react to it. As a matter of fact, if he blinked on the play, I don't even think he would have realized that he got hit by the ball. That's, of course, why you spin hundreds upon thousands of dollars on catcher's gear. So that way when, you know, a comebacker comes right into your face, you are okay. So he got his money's worth there. Now the 0-1 is a pickup play back over to Voltaggio as Voltaggio was trying to steal. He's trying to get back to first now on a pickle, but the Comets will finally catch a base runner stealing. And on the 10th base running attempt for the Renegades, they will be thrown out for the first time in this game. 9-for-10 on stolen bases as Voltaggio is thrown out. Count's still 0-1 now with the first out. As Nathan hits this one to deep left field, and it is caught by the left fielder on a jumping play on the warning track. What a play there. Here now is Matthew Leinerman. Leinerman with two out. Takes a pitch in there for a strike, 0-1. Leinerman 0 for 2 on the afternoon with a walk and a run scored.
Took a sweet time on
0-1, here it comes. Fastball in there for a strike, 0-2. And Leinerman, who was in set down on strikes, looking in danger now, 0-2 of getting set down, looking again. And it's another backwards K. Three straight strikes there to Leinerman to end the inning. So the Renegades able to plate one of them on a Stevie Hom home run to increase the lead by a score of 4-0. We'll head into the top end of the sixth, 4-0 Renegades.
Hey guys, Isabella Gomez filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to smokeybear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
We got a new pitcher to tell you about. It is the Los Angeles-born right-handed pitcher, Matthew Leinerman. This is going to be the first time I'm actually seeing him pitch so far this season. He doesn't pitch very often. It's his second appearance on the season. Only has an inning pitched, and in that inning, he walked three of them, struck out one. So he has a case through nine of exactly nine and no ERA on the season. So really, the measurables don't really hold too much value, especially it's only his second appearance on the season. So his first pitch is a fastball swung on and missed there on the elevated inside part of the plate there, up and in on the right-handed batter. Number one, Darion Davis, as Darion takes his 0-1, missing the zone, 1-1. Swung on and missed there from Darion, and it broke down his swing, losing his footing there on the 1-1 swing and a miss there. Let's talk about Leinerman's pitches. He's got a fastball, curveball, slider, and changeup. Here comes the 1-2. Fastball outside and missed, 2-2. So now the 2-2 to Leinerman. It's a changeup, missing the zone there, 3-2. Darion Davis batting at 146 to start this game, 6 driven in, and also a triple on the season. 222 on bases. This is a comebacker that looked like it was off the glove there of Matthew Leinerman. And everybody said, oh, shh. you know what I mean, as it looked like that might have been off of his, somewhere off of the upper body of him, but he was able to get his glove off of it there, so nothing touching his skin. It was a 4-3 ground out there as Owen Prendergast is playing at second base now in position for Matthew Leinerman, who is pitching now. And his 0-0 in there for a strike to the next batter, number 5, Octavio Martinez, who did not like that strike call there. 0-1 in there for a strike, making it 0-2 now. Now with the 0-2 to Liner, or to Octavio. Well outside for a ball there. So now the 1-2. Fastball challenge inside, and Martinez able to foul it off. One, two, here it comes again. On the ground. No, it is stabbed over there by Upton, and he is able to make a really nice acrobatic play there for the 3 unassisted in the second out of the inning. Those are the only defensive changes to be noted about is Upton playing at first and Prendergast playing at second now. As the 0-0 from Leinerman missing the zone, 1-0. Now Leinerman gets a sign from Wood, kicks and deals. It's a fastball in there for a strike. 1-1 the count. Jalen Edmonds, the batter for the Comets. Here comes the 1-1. Fastball flared and fouled to the right side, 1-2. And Ethan Liao, he tried to come out to give the home plate umpire some fresh balls, but home plate umpire said, no, I don't need your balls. 1-2, here it comes. Check swing on a curveball, missing the zone, and no swing. So Edmund stays alive there by the skin, by the skin of his teeth. 2-2. And it's a curveball that Leinerman loses his footing on and trips as he's throwing it, still gets the strikeout looking. I think he got the strikeout looking because Edmonds got so confused about him falling down on throwing that pitch. But nonetheless, it is a backwards K and an end of the inning, a 1-2-3 inning for Matthew Leinerman. We'll head into the bottom end of the sixth. It is 4-0 Renegades. So very, very unusual, I guess you could say. Unusual third strike there thrown by Leinerman ended up ending the inning for the Renegades. And still on the mound is going to be Rob Crivello. And he will be facing Calvillo, Nystrom, and Eric Hockey. We are in the bottom end of the sixth. 4-0 Renegades as Calvillo lines this one to the gap. And it gets down for another base hit. Extra bases for Calvillo. He is going to round second, trying for his second triple of the game. He's going to head first, dive. He is out. Oh. And so Calvillo was ever so close to his second triple of the game. But as it is, it'll be ruled a double and a throwout at second base. So here now is Nystrom, and his 0-0 missing the zone is 1-0 fouled off to the left side. 1-1 now. And the 1-1 missing the zone from Crivello. 2-1 the count now. Nystrom, high and deep to center field. It is gone! Bye! Bye! Baby! Nystrom with his 10th home run of the season. And Jackson Nystrom just keeps the clinic going. The freshman utility outfielder continuing his unbelievable season. As Eric Hockey is now up and his 0-0 misses the zone. 1-0 the count now. And the 1-0 in there for a strike. 1-1. Here comes the 1-1 now to Aaron Cocky, and it's well on the outside corner, called a strike there. Whoa. Is all I'm going to say. 1-2 now to Aaron Cocky. Crivello kicking and dealing. Fastball. Too far inside and past the catcher. And the 2-2 to Eric Hockey, bouncing to the plate, so he's going to run the count full now. 3-2. And his 3-2 fouled off to the right side. On deck is going to be Joe Silva's spot, and it is Shea Upton who is on the on-deck circle. So you can close the book on Silva, of course. Although we established that last half inning, as the 3-2 in there, strike three called. And so here now is Shea Upton. As Upton lines this one to left field and deep, it is gone again! Bye, bye, baby! Shea Upton with his first home run of the season. And right when I was about to announce his stats, he hits his first home run of the season. Shea Upton making this now a 6-0 game. Here now is Josh Algren to try and keep the rally going. Two solo home runs for the Renegades here, as his 0-0 somehow finds the zone on a well low and outside pitch for a strike there. Here comes the 0-1 on the ground to the right side. Diving play by the first baseman, throws it back to first in time for the out. And so the inning is now over, but not before Shea Upton and Jackson Nystrom make me scream the beautiful bye-bye baby. And we will now head to the top end of the seventh It is 6-0 in favor of the Renegades.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
And so we have a pitching change for you. And it looks like now Matthew Leiderman's afternoon is completely done, as Josh Algorin will now be pitching for the Renegades. And let's talk about Algorin's season at the plate. If we can even talk about it. Where? No, we cannot. Is this his first appearance? It is. All right, so we have nothing to talk about except his pitch types. All right, let's do it. So Algorin is got a fastball, sinker, slider, and changeup. It'll be his first appearance on this season. I thought that might be the case, but I didn't want to sound like an idiot and say that, and then all of a sudden it was not correct. So there's that. They'll be facing, to start off, Jesus Contreras. Contreras. And so far, Comets held to one hit on the afternoon. As it is Contreras is 0-0 in there for a strike. No, missed the zone. Wow. That's all I'm going to say. 1-0, here it comes. Low that time, 2-1. And now the 2-1, here it comes. Fastball line into center field for a base hit into the gap. Contreras rounding first and heading to second. The ball hasn't been fielded. He's rounding third or second now, heading to third. The throw from Stevie Hom, not in time, and it gets behind Calvillo, and Algorin able to cover it there before danger struck even harder there. And Contreras now on the ground, and that is not something you want to see there. He is in pain right now. As he just hit the second hit of the game for the Comets, and now he is down. I think he might be out of breath because nobody is coming out to his aid. Jeff is on the field, but not coming to him. And yeah, he's out of breath, I guess. I have no idea. He's not hurt, luckily, but everybody's laughing over there about it now. Ah, yes. The family jewels were attacked on that play. That's what happened. You guys know what I'm talking about. Man, that's indicative of their afternoon so far. And probably want to try and find, you know, something to just lighten it up. And there it is. It's a base hit there from number 3, Carson, to plate home the first run for the Comets on an RBI single. And so the Comets now showing some late game life here. And now batting is going to be Solomon Pope. The first baseman, right fielder combination, freshman. As he checks his swing there on an 0-0 delivery from Algorin. But it goes all the way there and swings and misses. 0-1 is the count. Here comes the 0-1. Fouled off to the right side. Upton ranging all the way over, and he almost had a play there, as that was not out of play there, but it just didn't stay in the air long enough. So Upton, great job over there, but just another one of those plays where it's a great effort and nothing comes out of it, unfortunately. So now the 0-2, here it comes. It's a curveball in there that misses the zone, 1-2. Algorin now with this 1-2. Here it comes home. Fastball swung on and missed there by Pope. K.O. Kalani Sibiana. Sibian, my goodness. Sibian now batting and swings and misses at his 0-0 delivery. Here comes the 0-1 now from Algarin to Sibian. Elevated and outside for a ball. And so now the 1-1, Algorin kicks and deals, swung on and missed there on the 1-1 delivery. And actually, according to the home plate umpire, foul tip back into the glove of Nathan Wood. So 1-2 now. Yeah, swing and a miss, foul tip into the glove, same exact thing. Here it comes, swung on and missed there. Algorin with a power fastball to entice the swing and miss there. On the upper inner half of the plate, here now is the batter number 26. Ikaz Balsetti, I believe it is. I'm gonna go by his first name, Aldo. Aldo, with a pitch on the outside, missing the zone. And Aldo batting at 136 to start this game. The 1-0, here it comes. Fouled off to the right side. 1-1 now. Here comes the 1-1 from Josh Algorin. Here it comes. Slider in there for a strike. Wow. What movement there from Josh Algorin. Those are one of the most beautiful pitches you'll ever see, is a moving slider. Super hard to hit. Here comes the 1-2. Slider swung on and missed. Enticing another strikeout. Swung right through the slider there was Aldo, and we will head into the bottom end of the seventh. Score is 6-1, Renegades. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
I tell my son I love you every single day. Now my dad has never said that to me, not because he doesn't love me, but because culturally it wasn't comfortable for him. Now that he's a grandfather, he says, I love you to my son every time he sees him. My advice to all the fathers out there, forget the cultural restrictions. They grow up way too fast for you to waste even a single precious moment.
All right, folks, we are back here on the Ohlone College Fremont campus. This is Armando Galan, and we are in the bottom end of the seventh inning. It's going to be Stevie Hom, Nino Voltaggio, and Nathan Wood all due up here in the bottom half of the seventh inning. And so far, it's just been all Renegades, but it hasn't been, a full and concise game from the Renegades. Although very recently, the bats have been getting alive. Three solo home runs, one of them belonging to Stevie Hom. So we've had 305 people listening in so far. Oh, and you're kidding me. The stream shut off. And so we are going to continue recording the rest of this game. I don't know why this stream shut off on us again, but it did. Unbelievable. Spend how much money on this equipment and it still doesn't work? So Stevie Hom now up, and his 0-0 missing the zone, 1-0. And so I'll try to get the stream back up and rolling, but what I'll do also is I'll just delete... I'll delete the extra stream that I'm about to put up right now and then just upload this raw video footage together, all pieced together through the magic of editing. But it's just going to add a ton of extra hours for no reason because our network decided to shut off for no apparent reason. So thank you, network. You're wonderful, T-Mobile. All right, I'm done. 1-0 was missed to Stevie Hom, and... the 2-0 in there for a strike. So let's get the stream back up and rolling now. Unbelievable. I cannot believe that that happened. Oh, and yeah. So the 2-1, oh, worn by Stevie Hom there.
What? That's insane. You want to get it like hit in the face or something?
And...
stupidest thing.
Wow, so they're going to say no hit by pitch there on Stevie Hom because of the reaction there. So they're going to award a strike on the hit by pitch there on the reaction by Stevie Hom. And that was nothing that he did differently there, as his 2-2 is way, way inside and high there. And Jack Hom voicing his discontent there, and I'm exactly with him. 3-2 swung on and missed by Stevie Hom, and that is a controversial strikeout, to say the least. Here now is Owen Prendergast. And he is in for... it is, he's in for Nino Voltaggio. So I guess they're going to say that Stevie Hom was crowding the plate there on the hit by pitch. I have no idea. 1-0, missing the zone to Prendergast. 2-0 now. Prendergast batting at 276 to start this game with a home run as he check swings there on the 2-0 delivery, and it's a strike. Prendergast now 2-1, line to the or grounded to the right side and off the glove of the first baseman, and Prendergast able to beat it out as the throw was offline back to first. So that's going to be officially ruled a base hit for Owen Prendergast, and here now is Nathan Wood. So I want to apologize again for our rampant connection issues. I want to apologize that T-Mobile is the service that we are stuck with. I have no idea why the stream shut off, but it did. So it's a bit frustrating, but we'll upload the full raw footage later. It'll be like nothing ever happened. As Prendergast is going to try and steal second. He is safe, and the Renegades are 10 for 11 now on stolen bases. And the pitch inside, it was called a ball, so the count now is 1-0. And so now with the 1-0, here it comes home. And it hits Nathan Wood on the hands. And that is officially going to be ruled a hit by pitch. Wonderful. Here now is Ethan Liao. And Ethan Liao batting at 417 to start this game, a 393 on base percentage and a 583 slugging. Not very often that you see an on base percentage that's lower than your batting average. Here's your 0-0. Too high and missing the zone there. Count now 1-0. So now with the 1-0, Liao awaits. Here it comes. It's a fastball that bounces to the plate. No runners will move up, though. Forgot to light up first base there. There we go. So now with the 2-0, Liao fastball fouled off to the right side. Two and one the count. And so now with the 2-1, line to the left side for a base hit. And Prendergast is going to come home and a throw to third to try and get Nathan Wood. And it's going to go offline because nobody was standing on third. And so on the throwing error, Liao is able to move up to second on the play. So I believe that it's going to be scored a base hit and a throwing error. Or at least that's how it should be scored. And Prendergast scores. Wood goes to third. Liao goes to second on the play. Here now is Calvillo. Score now 7-1 in favor of the Renegades. As Calvillo takes a pitch on the 0-0 count, which was a fastball for a strike. His 0-1 line to the right side and caught for the first out of the inning. So here now is Jackson Nystrom in his last opportunity. He hit his 10th home run of the season, which was just an inning ago. He is 2-for-2 with two walks, so he has yet to be retired in this game. Here comes his 0-0, and it is popped straight up into deep left field. And it'll be caught for the final out. Sorry, there was two outs there on that play. So that'll be caught for the final out. And the Renegades plating one of them there in this bottom end of the seventh. We'll head into the top end of the eighth. Score 7-1. But we're not going to go to commercial break. I'm going to quickly explain here what's going to happen with the remaining footage. So, unfortunately, we ran into another problem today with our stream shutting off on us. And this is a bit of a frustrating, development because, you know, we try our hardest to have equipment that is not going to shut off on us midstream. I don't know why this hotspot has done it twice to us now, but luckily I was recording this entire game separately from the stream, so YouTube has a way of uploading from a current video that has been uploaded already or a current stream that has been uploading. YouTube has a way of us uploading additional footage that is missed. So this stream that you're watching, as soon as it's done, I'm going to delete it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to piece together all the recorded footage and upload it on the actual raw stream that we had before it was shut down. The one that is uploaded now and available for you to listen to. So apologies for the confusion. I don't know why this happens. It shuts off, and there's no reason why it should have. We never went offline once, and our bit rates are fine. Our frames per second are fine. As a matter of fact, I have 60 frames right now, which I don't usually have. I usually have about 58 frames per second. But anyways, I'm speaking specs and computer knowledge that most people won't even care to listen to or understand in any capacity whatsoever. Unfortunately, it's just, that's how, like, this is gone. It's just unfortunate that this stream shut off on us. So, man, that's just unfortunate. But yeah, so we'll be able to listen to the rest of the game. You guys will be able to listen to the rest of the game after I am able to upload and piece together everything that we missed up until this point, which will happen, like, let's say maybe around 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. As play resumes here, the next batter is number 12, Emeon O'Leary, the leadoff batter for the Comets, and our pitcher is a new pitcher for the Renegades, who is also making his first appearance of the season. It is Owen Prendergast.
Did you get those first two guys?
Hey. And I wonder if Owen, Owen doesn't even have, we don't even have pitching information on Owen, because he's not listed as a pitcher, but his first three pitches, strike one, strike two, and a swinging strike three to start the inning here for Prendergast. So Darion Davis now going to hit for the Comets. It's been a bit of an interesting day for pitchers here at Ohlone College, as Nystrom found a ball in deep left field that he just threw back into the infield. All right, and so Nick Parker playing at second base now, as Owens, O-O, is lined to deep center field. Liao ranging all the way over but cannot quite make the play. It lands right in front of him as he was just a step behind it. So that'll be a double there for Darion Davis. And, I mean, it's 400 feet to straightaway center. That ball was hit about 397 feet. That just gives you an idea. Octavio Martinez now up to hit. And Martinez batting at 214 to start this game. As Owen is going to step off and call for time, and Nathan Boy going to go out there and talk to him. And so this is pretty interesting. I didn't think that when I woke up this morning and asked for, really when I asked for an excused absence from class today on Saturday, I did not expect that we were going to see Josh Algorin and Owen Prendergast pitching on the mound for the Renegades, or even Matthew Leinerman for that matter. I mean, well, it's been a pretty unique and interesting day here on the mound for the Renegades, as Prendergast comes back with a 0-0 that misses the zone, 1-0. Don't even know what he throws. Let's see if I can maybe pick up some of the pitches here as the inning progresses. The 1-0 from Prendergast, here it comes. That was a fastball that missed the zone, 2-0. But yeah, you guys will be able to listen to the rest of the game. I'll be streaming until this game is over, of course. And I'll piece together everything through the magic of editing. I'll piece together everything that we missed. Here comes the 2-0, bouncing to the plate and behind Nathan Wood there. And Darion Davis is able to move up to third on that play. I don't know if that would be a pass ball there or a wild pitch. I would imagine a wild pitch since it bounced the plate and through the legs of Nathan Wood. I need baseball to come back so that way I can see, you know, clear examples again. I'm kind of out of that baseball brain again. 2-1, and it is this time it is a pass ball by Nathan Wood on a pitch that was well outside, and it was throughout his glove, and Davis was able to come all the way around to score there. It is 7-2 now. So good base running there out of Darion Davis. Count now 3-1. 3-1, here it comes. Popped straight up by Martinez into foul territory in at the third base side. Now pushing back into the infield and fair territory, and Calvillo is able to make the play there for the second out. Apologies, I didn't realize I didn't update the outs there. Here we go. Two out now. Prendergast with a 0-0 in there for a strike to make the count now 0-1. Trying to read the who this batter is, but I can't tell the number. I think it might be Edmonds, but he won't turn around. It is Edmonds, and the 0-1 swung on and missed there, 0-2. So Jalen Edmonds, the batter. So now with the 0-2, Prendergast, another fastball, bounces to the plate. And on that 0-1 pitch that was a swung on strike, it was a curveball that was swung on and missed by Edmonds there. So now 1-2. Owen kicks and deals, fastball, missing the zone, 2-2. Two now from Prendergast. Here it comes. Fastball. Check swung. Strike three. So we'll head into the bottom end of the seventh. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Or bottom end of the eighth, rather. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
All right, folks, and we are here now on the bottom end of the eighth inning. And this is about the time that we start seeing some changes. And when I say changes, I mean literally change after change after change after change after change after change. That's the current baseball way. And so to start it off, we have Mahida Tabata coming in now for Jackson Nystrom's spot, and so Mahi gets his first at-bat of this game. Let's talk about his season so far. Batting at .262 to start the game. He has 3 home runs on the season, 17 driven in, on base of .403 and slugging at .443. His first pitch was missed. Count now 1-0. And now the 1-0 fouled off down the line. Got a new pitcher to tell you about. It's Jalen Edmonds. He's a right-hander. So Mahi now waiting is 1-1. Here it comes from Edmonds. It's a chain or slider missing the zone. 2-1. So now 2-1. Mahi lines this one foul to the left side. Hey, straighten that out. You got yourself a double right there.
Come on, Mahi. Let's go.
Oh, 2-2 now. Mahi on the ground to the left side, through the infield for a base hit. So Mahi will find a way aboard. And here now is Shea Upton, and he moved his way up in the lineup. No, he did not. What am I saying here? So, Mahi came in for Eric Hockey's spot, my bad. As he was almost picked off there at first base. So, he moved up for Eric Hockey's spot, not Nystrom's spot. And Upton is now up. Upton with a home run on the afternoon. 1-for-1. Mahi now trying to steal second. The throw is good. Not in time. And the Renegades now 11-for-12 today in stolen bases. Pitch was called a strike there on the 0-0 delivery. So here now comes the 0-1 to Upton. Fastball outside for a strike. So now with the 0-2, Upton awaits. Here it comes. Fastball bouncing to the plate. 1-2. And so again, folks, want to say I will not be able to do our game for tomorrow against Deonza or the Deonza game on Friday. We will be diverting resources to the last of two home games for our softball team. And then on Friday, I'm in class all day. 1-2, line into the gap, and it's going to get down for a base hit. Mahi's only going to move up to third, though, and Upton will have a base hit. So he is 2-for-2 on the afternoon. Here now is Nick Parker, and he is in for Josh's spot. Parker's season so far, 182 batting, 321 on base, and 182 slugging, 2 driven in on the season for him. As Upton dives back at first on a pickoff play there. And Parker called back over by Coach Curran. It seems like they are talking some strategy here of some sort. Not sure what. Not sure who. Not sure why. I don't know. I'm just trying to come up with anything here, folks. It's been a filler afternoon for me. Running out of things to say here. It is 5 p.m. on the Fremont campus. So here comes the 0-0 now to Nick Parker. He's going to bunt. Both runners are stealing there. And safe is going to be Upton. So make that now 12 for 13. And the clinic just keeps rolling here for the Renegades, base running wise. So now with the 0-1, I imagine both runners are going to steal here. And Parker is going to lay down a bunt. The current special, here it comes. It's a slider that bounces to the plate, 1-1. Come on, give it to me, folks. 1-1, now to Parker. Fastball. Fouled off back to the screen. And those were one of those moments where you're glad there's a screen there. Otherwise, it would have been a comeback right into somebody's face here in the front row. Oh, wait, there's nobody sitting in the front row today. Except one man, the lone man in green. 1-2, here it comes. Curveball missing the zone. 2-2. Now the 2-2. Here it comes. Parker takes inside. Good take there. 3-2 now. Still none out here in this bottom end of the eighth inning. Emmett Finney on deck for Stevie Hom's spot. 3-2, here it comes. Inside, strike three called. Looked like the same exact pitch that was called ball two there. I just noticed I didn't even light up second base there for Nick Parker. And Stevie Hom now going to come up to hit instead of, well, Finney's going to move down. Okay, so Finney, it looked like he was on the on-deck circle, but now Stevie is going to come up to hit. So here now is Stevie. He's going to lay down a bunt, and it's a good one. It's the current special down the left field, or down the third baseline, and it goes foul. Both runners were moving their pre-pitch motion, and it goes foul down the line. So now with the 0-1, and you know what? That's actually really interesting, too, because you would think Stevie Hom here, definitely swinging away, wasn't there. Especially when he is 1-for-3 on the afternoon as he lines this one into center field, and that's going to be a base hit. One run will score, and that is Mahi who scores, and it's an RBI single for Stevie Hom. Here now is Emmett Finney. It is 8-2 rather here on the Fremont campus. 2-for-4 is Stevie Hom in the afternoon. So Finney coming in for the DH spot. And Emmett. And a balk is going to be called here on the Comets. So Upton is going to come up to score. And Stevie is going to move up to second there. It is 9-2 now, Renegades. And man, when it rains, it pours, I guess. The Comets just... Error after error today. This is one that they probably want to just put behind them. Oh, here it comes. Finney fouled off to the right side. It looks like it's playable. And it was the first baseman traveling all the way over Pope, Solomon Pope, but couldn't quite make the play there. But as it is, it's just a long strike, 0-1. Emmett Finney now with the 0-1. Here it comes. Check swing that gets past the catcher, and Stevie Hom is going to move up to third there. And no swing, says the home plate umpire, so Finney. Now in the count, 1-1. Infield is going to play in here, and so is the outfield on this 1-1 count as Finney takes inside and it hits him. And now batting is going to be Calvin Nguyen. Calvin Nguyen batting at .429 to start this game, on base of .600 and slugging at .786, two home runs and seven driven in. Finney is going to steal here. The throw back to second is too high, and the shortstop covering there able to protect the wild throw there. But guess what, folks? 13 for 14 is the Renegades base running today, stealing. On stealing attempts, 13 for 14. That is some average right there. And so Nguyen now going to, with his 1-0, foul off to the right side. Come on, tell me the current special's on the way. We've been manifesting it all day long. Tell me the current special's on the way. Please. 1-1 count, two runners on, perfect time with only one out. Let's do it. What do you say, folks? Here comes the 1-1, and here it comes. It is a bunt down the third baseline. Stevie's going to score. Nguyen is out at first, and Finney is going to score. Two-run score on the current special. And perfectly ran there by the Renegades. Finally! I've been waiting for that all afternoon, the current special, man. Goodness. So here now is Ethan Liao, and the Renegades have had seven batters come up to the plate so far in this bottom end of the first, as the 1-0 misses the zone. 2-0 now to Liao. Here it comes, bouncing to the plate, 3-0. Liao now, 3-0. Fastball missing the zone, and he is going to walk. And there are two out as the eighth hitter of this inning comes up to the plate in the form of Cameron Calvillo. Here comes the 0-0. Inside, missing the zone, 1-0. Calvillo now with the 1-0. Here comes, fastball in there for a strike. So the 1-1 now. Line to the left side and foul. 1-2. Calvillo with the 1-2. Awaiting. Here it comes. Swung on and missed, and mercifully the inning is over. Not before the Renegades are able to plate four of them here. And the score is now 11-2 in favor of the Renegades. We'll head into the top end of the ninth inning. Renegades lead by 9.
Hey guys, Isabella Gomez filling in for Smokey Bear because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to smokeybear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
All right, folks, we have made it to the ninth inning. And man, it has been a long afternoon here on the Fremont campus. This game started at 2:30, and it feels like it's 7:30 instead of 5:12 p.m. It's just that this game has just been going on long. There's been long half innings, really long drawn-out sequences. It's just one of those games that are just like, ooh, man, this has been a drag.
Hey,
it's been a drag. It's been a drag. So, you know, feels nice to be in the ninth inning now. We got some defensive changes to tell you about, though, here for the Renegades. Voltaggio is playing in left field now. Mahi playing in right field. And Liao playing in center field. Stevie still playing at short. He's the only one who is staying in his actual position, his starting position. Biniam Gebhardt playing at third base. Calvin Nguyen at catcher. And at first base, Shea Upton. At second base, Owen Prendergast. And on the mound is Cameron Calvillo. Calvillo with his fourth appearance on the season, has a 6 ERA, no K's through 9. He hasn't recorded a strikeout yet. 4 walks, 2 earned runs off of 2 runs, total runs. 4 hits given up, 3 innings pitched. Making his fourth appearance on the season. Tasked with getting 3 outs and improving the Renegades to 14-6-1. And he'll be facing Jesus Contreras. As Contreras takes a fastball in their first strike, 0-1 is the count. Now Contreras awaiting his 0-1. Bender that misses the zone there by Calvillo, 1-1. So now the 1-1, fastball missing the zone, 2-1. Two-one now from Calvillo, fouled off to the left side. 2-2. Two-two, line into right center field for a base hit. And is that Manado to what? When did this happen? I didn't even notice this. All right, folks. Somehow Manado has teleported onto the field and swapped places with Owen without me even realizing it. I even announced right before the at bat, Owen was in. All right, so Manado is playing at second base now, folks. That is news to me. As he almost made a jumping play there at second base. As Calvillo throws a first pitch strike there to the new batter, Ensel Carson. Carson now with his 0-1 on the outside corner, missing the zone, 1-1. Oh, The 1-1 on the ground to the left side and fouled. 1-2 now. As Carson awaits his 1-2, Calvillo gets the sign from Nguyen. Here it comes. On the ground, Tatano has it. Goes to second for one. Back to first. Not in time. But Minato looking like a natural second baseman there. Getting the pick at second base and flipping it over to Stevie Hom for the first out there of the inning. Almost turned two on his first chance playing second base. Hey, Minato, maybe your future lies there, huh? And the next batter is going to be Solomon Pope as this pitch gets away from Nguyen and Carson is able to move up 90 feet. Count now 1-0. And Solomon Pope. He's a right fielder, first baseman combination. Freshman. Fastball check, or no, foul tipped back. And count now 1-1. The 1-1 now. In there for a strike on a curveball there from Calvillo. 1-2. The 1-2, well outside for a ball. 2-2. Calvillo with his 2-2 now with one out. Getting ready, kicks and deals. It's a fastball, swung on and missed by Pope. There are now two out in the inning. One out remaining in this game. Here now, Simeon. As Calvillo. Checks the runner at second, now kicks and deals. It's a fastball elevated and outside for a ball. So now with the 1-0, Calvillo. Fastball swung on and missed there. Calvillo awaiting. Here comes. Popped up and foul to the right side. 1-2. And so now with the 1-2 from Calvillo, here comes home. Fastball swung on and missed, and the game is now over. The Renegades improved to 14-6-1 on this season and will head into the Dianza three-game set, looking like their best versions of themselves on the season so far. And as for the Contra Costa Comets, they are going to drop to 1-19 on the season. And we'll look to try and find consistency in their next game. Folks, I've been saying, I've had these words on my mind since the first inning. This game is over. And I would like to thank you all so much for listening. We'll be back tomorrow with some softball action. As I said before, we will be diverting resources to our softball team tomorrow. And we'll have to be making the sacrifice of the baseball team. So if you want baseball action, best to come on out. 2:30 first pitch time, as well as Friday afternoon, 2:30 first pitch time, can't make it out for that one either. So I want to thank you all so much for listening, and good night, everybody. Be well, be safe. Thank you for listening.